Okay, good day again. ITE 314 Advanced Database Systems. Student Activity Sheet Number 4. Okay. So, again, our lesson title for today, Entity Relationship Modeling. So, lesson objectives at the end of this session, students should be able to first be acquainted with the conventions used in modeling entities, attributes, and relationships in databases. Number two, understand the different use of symbols in ER diagram. Materials as for the reference, this one, okay? Let's check. Okay. So, you can check the reference of this module in this site. Okay. Check this out. Okay. Module 4 reference. Okay. Okay. So, dire makita ninyo mga iba't ibang mga references ng ating module number 4. Okay? So, let's proceed to our module. Okay? School productivity tip, schedule doing practice drills like the ones in this module. 2 more times this week, spacing your practice time will help you master the process. Okay. So, practice makes you perfect. So, practice, master mo gid na until one day you'll become skilled. Good morning or good day. Again, you've learned the basic concept of relational model, the CADS-12 rule of RDBMS, and the different types of database keys. For today's session, we will be dealing with Entity Relationship Model, or ERD, which was described in database models. This topic includes 1, basic concept of ER model, 2, symbols used in ER diagram, and the 3rd, creating ER diagram. So, for the activity 1, what I know chart, part 1, 3 minutes. The table below shows some questions that are relevant to our LOs or learning outcome. Please go through column 2 and write in column 1 your answers on what you initially know about our topic. So, answer this what I know table column. So, before you will dive into the module, so all answers here are accepted and valid. So, please answer. So, for the question, what do you understand by Entity Relationship Model, or ERM? 2, why do you need ER model? Nga kailan? What can we do with it? And the 3rd, how does ERD components affects database design? Cite 1 example. Okay. So what I learned, so please answer what I learned today after this module. So for the main lesson, entity relationship model, what is ER modeling? Okay. So for the entity relationship model is a high level conceptual data model diagram. ER modeling helps you to analyze data requirements systematically to produce a well-designed database. The entity relation model represents real-world entities and the relationship between them. It is considered a best practice to complete ER modeling before complementing your database. So, for the ER modeling helps you to analyze data requirements systematically to produce a well-designed database. So, gaano ka importante ang entity relational model. Okay? Para makakuha sang systematically, okay, nga and well-designed database. Okay? Doon kung bagado, parehas lang naman patindog ko sa balay. So, kailan mo na isang plano. Okay? Para nga maging systematic ang inyong balay. What do I mean by systematic? Siyempre, ang flows ng tubig, ang kung paano nga ang inyong nga mga entrances sang pagkanto sa rooms and so on and so forth. So dapat systematic, okay, and well designed. So para nga bamukunda mo damo ka na record, as you notice, okay, just like mine. Okay, for example, last time, ay sorry langit iyan na galing ka ano. Ari, makita nyo na eh. So, dire, oh. Makita nyo na yung ano, ang mga bookmarks. Test mic. Makita nyo na yung bookmarks. Anyone can hear me?
Yes, sir.
Ang mga bookmarks yun din, makita nyo na eh. Kabalo ka mo mag-ubra sa
bookmarks? Yes, sir.
Kabalo ka mo mag-ubra sa bookmarks? Are, kabalo ko mo sino yung mag-ubra? Once nga may ara ka sa ano, Google account. Okay. Kung may ara ka na sa Google account, pwede ka na yung ka-ubra. For example, nag-login ka sa imo Google, no? Oh. Tapos, oh, wala din. Oh. Are na lang. Tunay sa itin yan. Nan. Kamunin yung Google mo. Now, for, by default, hindi na siya visible. Okay? All you need to do is to click this button. Okay? I think, let me see. Wait lang. Right click and then hari sagali, oh. Right click muna niyo. Hari tapos, show bookmark bar. So, kung i-disable ko na, ara. Refresh. F5 lang. Ito, ang tabi ko na matabo. Ah, hindi mag-iapon. Ilang kid. Sa ano siguro. Sa may bookmark, bookmark manager. Sa din na saman. Wait lang. Pero kung makita nyo ni, maka-access kasi na, okay, once nga nakasync na niyo, nakasync ng imong bookmarks, okay, pwede mo na doon, pwede ka na doon kaubra sa bookmarks, for example, sini, notes, websites, okay, so, do press lang na sang nag-ubra ka sa ano, minus, okay, for example, butang ka doon bookmarks mo, my Facebook account, my or YouTube channel, okay, YouTube channels. So kung makakadto ka karon sa YouTube channels, for example, YouTube, okay, and then sample ala,
if you're like me and
nagadto ka na da. And then, i-save mo siya, right-click, and then add page. Pag add page mo, okay, okay lang. Ara na siya, oh. And then, another one, for example naman, is Facebook. Okay. Facebook. For Facebook, for example, add na lang, rename na lang. Rename. Links lang, butang ta, links. Okay, and then add page. Ah. So makita naton, pwede ka nakaubra sa imong mga minus diri. So pag click mo na, automatically makadto ka na ta. Ah. So amo na siyang technique dala, no? Okay. Now, para hindi ka magsala, kung damo-damo na record mo just like mine, ari, kay wala ko nakaplano noon na sa bookmarks ngini. So makita nyo damo damo ng record in sinsupornan. And so damo ng record. So damo na ko digin pang save, okay? Ng mga bookmarks o para hapos lang ang pag-access ang site. Okay? So now sa aton nga question. Okay. It is very important to have a knowledge, okay, in entity relational model. So para maging well designed and systematic ang aton nga database. So it is considered a best practice to complete ER modeling before implementing your database. So kayan lang yed nga may ara kasang prior knowledge before ka mag implement sang database. Paano mag-implement sang database? Okay, again, ari dilyo. O, diba? So, to access your SAMP, local hosting, ari gamit ang SAMP. Okay? So, let's dive into this module. Okay? History of ER models. ER diagrams are a visual tool which is helpful to represent the ER model. It was proposed by Peter Chen in 1971 to create a uniform convention which can be used for relational database and network. He aimed to use an ER model as a conceptual modeling approach. What is ER diagram? Ano yung tawag ng ER diagram? Entity relationship diagram, ERD, displays the relationships of entity set stored in a database. In other words, we can say that ER diagrams help you to explain the logical structure of database. Mabaka logical structure, okay, ano ba silingon sa logic? Ano brown mo kung nagutom? Anyone? Kung nagutom ka, ano brown mo?
Ngita pagkaon.
Hindi makaon.
Magkaon.
Oh, makaon. Kung natuyo ka, ano brown mo?
Tulog.
Tulog. Oh. Kung ano pa ginada? So, bichilingon, corresponding nga bagay sa imong question. Gusto mo makakwarta, ano brown mo? Ano brown mo kung gusto mo makakwarta? Loren?
Mangita obra.
Mangita obra o maobra? Maobra ka, diba? So muna na ang mga example na to, no? Logical. Mamba ka logical? Kung nauhaw ka, inom ka. Okay? Kung natuyo ka, tulog ka. Inso inso por. Logic lang na ginatawag. Logic dictates. Okay? Yung baga mag ginatawag na nga sala ang logic sang iba. Mga muna bala. So, let's dive into this module. Okay? The logical structure of database. At first look, an ER diagram looks very similar to the flowchart. Okay? Have you may ara na kamo sa prior knowledge in flowchart? May ara na kamo prior knowledge in flowchart? Test mic. May ara na, wala pa. Listen, sir. Flowchart.
May ara gamay, sir.
First year, sir.
About sa Python.
Okay, Python. Flowchart. This is a type of flowchart. Makita nyo na eh. Flowchart. For
yes,
example,
sir.
The scope of this flowchart is to log in using biometric. Okay? So, from the start, okay, scan finger. Ang finger mo, yung imong thumb. Tapos, compare scan finger with database. Kung pag-scan sa imong kamot, sa imong thumb, kung may match, pwede ka nakalagin. Welcome. Okay, welcome na. If not, no match, quit ka. Butsilingon, you are not registered. Okay? So pwede ka na pwede na ma-terminate ang session. Okay? This is an example of flowchart. Now, so to proceed, ambalya, it is similar to the flowchart. However, ER diagram includes many specialized symbols. Dumura mo siya kung mga specialized symbols like this. Okay? Hari siya, mga specialized symbols siya. Then, in its meanings makes this model unique. Okay? So, nagatag isang uniqueness. Okay? Para sa diagram. Components of the ER diagram, the model is based on three basic concepts. One, entities, attributes, and relationship. Now, for example, here in our sample flowchart, how many entities here? Pila ka bilog ang entity dire? Pila ka bilog ang entity dire sa flowchart? Hindi nyo ma-identify? Sige. Ma-proceed kita dyan ay sa sample. Okay. So, here in sample, okay. And, makita hindi? Kita. Student. Tapos, college. Okay. Student. And then, the college. Kamu ang student. Ano ang imong attributes? Hari. Student ID. Ba mo kung mag-ubra kita sa mga attributes, ginabatangan nato nina sa mga ano, mga unique identifier or unique name. O wala kita gahatag space. Kaya kung maghatag kita sa space, basi kung mag-break lang ka mga duwa. So, hindi ka maghatag space. An. Para sa din ang space. Di ba? So, proceed kita dire. Student underscore ID is an attribute of please follow me of stu may na internet
student.
Open ang camera bla sal, open lang imo camera gaw daw a camera ano gali ang unmute mo lang para maka interact ko sa imo. Student name Salo. Then student address. Kung sa din mo address. Kaya din ka. Nan.
Sa Tabarbara na, sir.
So meaning mga domain yung mga domain. Okay? Domain. Okay? So ang tawag sini, okay, the main domain na student ID name, okay. Ang attribute sa sina kung ano ang actual yung ID number. Lawaga gani ID number mo sal.
04-1920
Nan, amo ni siyaw. Thank you again. Amo ni actual. Okay? So proceed kita dire. Student name Salo. Ari siyaw. Nan. So wala lang di sa ano. Imuuntan lang ni email address. Ari man siya. Okay? So tanan niya na, tanan ni ang iyang attributes. Okay, ang domain niya na. And then this one, ano tawag natin sini? So, considered ni siya as a table. Okay? Wala. Zoom. Okay. Okay, ari, considered natin ini siya nga ano tawag ni? Table. Pwede natin mo consider nga table. Table sang student. So pwede natin mo tawag nga student. Okay. Student. Makita. Student underscore TBL. So amo na kami mag-label. Okay. Mas mayo pa, dream may label, pero ang iban wala label. Nan. So, amo na siya, no? Student underscore label. Ang ngalan sang table. Okay. So, proceed ta. Now, diri naman sa college, sa may college naman. Okay. Ano naman na? Sa college. So, sa college, pwede natin butangan niya or din na to. College. Cal. Score T B L. Amo na ngalan sa table. Okay? So consist of this one. Amo na yung table. So college ID and college name. Anong college name? Pinma UI. May college ID. So depende na siya. Kaya naka ano kita mo naka Pinma Education Network. Mga baka Pinma Education Network, damo-damo kita klase nga no nga schools in Pinma. If we can search the Pinma Education Network. So bachilingon, hindi lang isa ang naga-manage, okay? Hindi lang iya ka Pinma UI. Kundi damo-damo pa nga schools under sa Pinma Education. Okay, here are some of the colleges. Okay? So including dira ang Pinma UI. Okay? And get kita nyo. Ada siya. Mga schools under sa Pinma Education. Okay? So to proceed. Okay? For example, in university database, we might have entities for students, for college and lectures. Students entity can have attributes like roll number, name, and department ID. They might have relationships with course and lectures, and so on and so forth. So, without that proper database and ERD, ang aton nga record, magkramaal na. Okay? So, it's very important kaya ang aton nga database should well-designed and systematic. Okay? So, dere, sa components of ER diagram, entities, ang student, we can consider ang student as a entity. So, college as also considered as entity. Now, relationship.
Entity.
Ano ang ilang relationship? Ano? Relationship nila? Relationship nila. Now, kita nyo na ano? Katniel. Ano relationship? Ano ilang ano? Relationship? Name. Katniel. Kita nyo, di ba? Sino pa kinabalaan nyo? Gerald. Gerald Gidman.
Liskin.
Gerald Gidman. Ha?
Liskin, sir.
Liskin. Oh, ano pa?
Liskin.
Sino pa mga paborito nyo da? Ha? Si Kim kag sino gani? Si Kim kag si Miguel gani? Basta mo na, okay? Mga love team nga na. So, really, ano na, relationship ni nila na. Sa aton, dire, okay, in database, may nga tawag magkita relationship ni. Entities and attributes. Now, so let's proceed. Are, may example. Entity name. Person, place, object, event, or concept about which data is to be maintain. Example, car, student. So, did you know now how to identify the entity? Kabalo na akong mag-identify sa ang ginatawag na entity. So, sa example sa babaw, student can considered as entity. So, muna siya ang example na ito. Dre, sa mga example man sa references, hari ganun, ingkuhaan nyo man. Okay? So, let's proceed. Now, there is a sa attribute. Property of characteristic. Okay, anong characteristics? Okay, salo, guapa, maalam. Oh, beautiful, kung ano pagkaganda. Oh. So, ano mga characteristic niya or property, no? Of an entity. Example, color of car, entity name of student, entity. Okay, so kung paano mo siya i-describe? So that's what we call attribute. So i-describe mo depende sa sa context. Okay? Relation. Association between the instances of one or more entities. Okay, there is an example. Study in. Amo na sa ang relation niya. Relationship. Blue car belongs to student Jack. So kung anong relationship nila. So I hope you understand. So for the ER diagram symbols, so we have an entity is an object in the real world with an independent existence that can be differentiated from other objects. An entity might be, okay, one, an object with physical existence such as lecturer, student, or a car. An object with conceptual existence such as a course, a job, or position. Strong entity, o may dua klase. The strong and weak entity. Ano na sila? An entity is considered strong if it can consist apart from all its related entity. Weak entity, an entity is considered weak if its tables are existence dependent, that is, it can exist without relationship. So pwede mo sa gali mag-exist without relationship. Okay, galing tawag sina is weak with another entity. A weak entity is represented using double rectangular boxes. It is generally connected to another entity. So without relationship, weak entity na. Okay, strong entity kung pwede makonsider nyo mayara sa pa may ara sa sang okay, may connect or considered strong entity, it can exist apart from all its related entities. Okay, so related entities, magamba ka related, may common. Okay, each one of you has a common. Anong common nyo? One instructor, which is me. Tunay sa itin yan. So, amo nang inyo nga common. So, but silingon, weak or strong entity? Ano may ara ka mo? Strong or weak entity? Ha? Each one of you here has a common instructor in ITA 314. Now, ano may ara ka mo? Strong entity or weak entity?
Strong.
Kaya may ara ka mo sa common relationship or entity. Okay? An attribute is a characteristic of entities. May A to D kita, no? Simple attributes. Simple attributes are those drawn from the atomic value domains. They are also called single value attributes. In the company database, an example of this would be name equals John, age equals 23. So, that's what we call a simple attribute. Okay? So, for the composite attribute, composite attributes are those that consist of hierarchy of attributes. Okay? Ano mga hierarchy attributes natin? Ha? So, from me, okay, hierarchy from top to bottom, attributes ko is kamo, students. My students. Okay? Ang ano pa kaya ng pwede i-considered nga attribute. Okay? ang inyong sub-details, okay? Those are the attributes nga pwede may connect sa ato nga composite attribute. So, pwede multi-valued attribute. Multi-valued attribute are attributes that have a set of values for each entity. Ano mga set of values each entity? Ano nato may ano, anong pwede naton may connector eh? Okay? For example, later ma-discuss nato na ang mga iban pagid. Mabamagi na tawag kita nga ano, one to one, one to many, many to one, or many to many. Okay? So, soon, maintindihan nyo na. So, derive. Attribute. Derived attributes are attributes that contains values calculated from other attributes. Oh, kumbaga, ano ka lang, grabber. No, grabber or nag-fetch ka lang. Okay? So, hindi halin sa imo ang attribute, halin sa iban nga entity. Okay? So, maano ta na, maintindihan ta na soon. Okay? Relationships are the glue that holds the tables together. Ano nag-hold sa aton? Subject with sections and schedule. Without the subject, schedule, and section, what will happen? Malain ang inyong teacher. So, wala na kita sang glue that mag-hold sa aton. So, they are used to connect related information between tables. Okay? So, para mag-connect kita, kamo mismo nga table na student, may attributes ka mo. Ako, may attributes mo ko. Para mag-connect kita nga dua, mag-connect kita nga kamo entity, ako entity. So, para mag-connect kita, dapat may relationships. Ano nga kung nga relationships na? Ang inyong subject, section, and what we call? Ang inyong schedule. Relationship is represented using diamonds or rhombus. So here are some of the example of the symbols na ginagamit sa may ER diagram. Entity or strong entity, weak entity, attribute, multi-valued attribute, relationship, weak relationship, and derived attribute. So proceed to activity 3, what I know chart. So answer nyo lang ni ang sa what I know chart after watching this video. Okay, then for the what activity 4, check for understanding, 5 minutes based from the content notes provided, what is being asked in each number, write your answer on the space provided. Okay, an attribute whose values can be calculated from related attributes blank. Ano na siya? Can be calculated. An answer. Patapos na. Pwede maka-copy and paste. Pwede para ano, para ginagrab yun lang ang attributes. Paano na? Answer. Wala. Pastra na. An answer? Wala answer? An answer? An attribute whose values can be calculated, related attributes values. It could be a, ano?
Derived attribute.
Derived attribute.
Derived.
Nan.
Derived, sir.
Yes. Thank you. For example, ang apelyido ni ang imo ang ano ang hindi. Dibla mga asawa ka? babae ka, mga asawa ka, apelyido mo sa buong salo. Pero, later on, kung mga asawa ka, mamana ka, ang apelyido sa asawahon mo, abanahon mo, amo nang imo apel?
Hindi ko mamana, sir.
Ay, hindi ka mamana. Ano lang, mga asawa lang?
Malaon sa salo, sir.
Si Pastrana na lang, bemig, amigo ka, Pastrana. Secret lang. Complicated.
Secret.
Now,
bayaran na, sir. Si Mateo.
Sige lang.
Si Pastra, Mateo, sir.
Ano pilido ni Mateo? Ano pilido, ya? Oh. For example, si Pastra, Loren Pastrana. Mamana.
Onios.
Oh.
Onios.
Onios. Oh, si Onios, yun, oh. Sige. Si Loren Pastrana, mamana na. Oh. Okay. Now, kung mamana siya, ang apelido ni Onios, kwaon niya sa uli. Okay? Meaning, amo ni sa ginatawag nga, derived attributes are calculated that contains values calculated from other attributes. Oh. Na. So, basically yun, pwede yan mag-grab. Okay? Ang apelido ni Onios. Number two. So, it is a derived attribute. ER models was proposed by blank.
Peter Chen.
Yeah. Ado, alam mo ba? So, very good, Peter Chen. Blank is a group of similar kind of entities. Huh? Similar entities. Oh. Similar entities, it is entity, di natin ibabaw ang entity set. Entity set, wala din sa module number, ano? Ari siya. Oh, wala din. But the answer is a group of similar kind of entities. It's called as entity sets. So, entity sets number 3. Or entity set. No? Basta magambal ka similar entities. Okay, entity set. True or false, a strong entity is a type of entity which doesn't have its key attribute. True or false? Doesn't have its key attributes. Amo niya yun ang strong and weak nyo ni. Doesn't have?
False, sir.
It's false. Thank you. Then number 4. Number 4 na o 5? 5. It defines the numerical attributes of relationship between two entities or entity sets. Defines numerical attributes of the relationship between two entities or entity sets. Anong sabat? Ha? Wala din sa sample. Babaw. Wala sample. Where's the sample? Okay. Sa module number 3 ito sa. It's called cardinality. Okay. Ang baka cardinality? Ano ganyan ang baka cardinality? Ha? Ari siya.
Lain ang cardinality, sir.
Ha? Ano? Total number of rows present in the table. Total number present in the table. kung pila ka bilog ang number of rows mo, oh, that what we call a, ano siya, example, an tuple or rows. Okay, total number of rows. So the question is, what are din ito, number 5, it defines the numerical attributes of the relationship between two entities or entity sets. Oh, cardinality is the correct answer. Relationship nila na here, di ba may relationships din sila, common relationships between the attributes, may common. Okay, and then also called also known as the total number of rows, so cardinality. So malas ang correct. Number 6, what are the three components of ER models?
Entities, attributes, relationship.
Yeah. So don't forget na entities, attributes, and relationships. Okay. Ano yung tatlo niyo? Next one, lesson wrap up. Okay. Okay. So don't answeran niyo na. So for the frequently asked question, what is the difference between? Okay. Wait lang kita. Wait lang.
FAQs. 1. What is the difference between primary key constraint and foreign key constraint? Ans. The primary key constraint is imposed on the column data to avoid null values and duplicate values. Primary key equals unique plus not null. Example, social security number, bank account number, bank routing number. On the other hand, a foreign key constraint is imposed on a column in the child table. The foreign key column value in the child table will always refer to primary key values in the parent table.
Oh. So, thank you so much. Alright, so next, our number 2 frequently asked question, please listen.
FAQs. 1. What is the difference between primary key constraint and foreign key constraint? Ans. The primary key constraint is imposed on the column data to avoid null values and duplicate.
Lain laway niya yating ugman. Lalaki ba iban? Yeah, are.
Ans. The primary key constraint is imposed on the column data to avoid null values and duplicate values. primary key equals unique plus not null. Example, social security number, bank account number, bank routing number. On the other hand, a foreign key constraint is imposed on a column in the child table. The foreign key column value in the child table will always refer to primary key values in the parent table.
For the number
2. What are the best practices for developing effective ER diagrams? ANDs. Eliminate any redundant entities or relationships. You need to make sure that all your entities and relationships are properly labeled. There may be various valid approaches to an ER diagram. You need to make sure that the ER diagram supports all the data you need to store. You should assure that each entity only appears a single time in the ER diagram. Name every relationship, entity, and attribute are represented on your diagram. Never connect relationships to each other. You should use colors to highlight important portions of the ER diagram.
Alright, so thank you so much. Text to speech. So some more questions. Alright, so